Things have changed, but not since the transitional government took over.
On the other side of town are white homes, plenty of them, for sale, owners gone. Even if blacks could afford to buy them, as the new year began, they were not allowed to. The Land Tenure Act, the instrument of discrimination that preserves certain areas for whites only, was still on the statute books. The transitional government promised to abolish it. Blacks were still waiting. This house has been on the market for several months. Four bedrooms, the deepest pool in town. Monty and June Pascoe are asking £12,000 for it, but they're open to offers. Monty Pascoe knows that the good times are over. He's off to South Africa.
Thank you, Timothy, but you didn't open that one, you stupid thing. But don't worry about it. We'll open it.
He can only take £800 with him, the legal limit.
Did you always believe that one day you would leave Rhodesia?
Never, ever. Now, I was one of the guys going to stay here and switch off the lights in Mtolia. I was going to switch off the lights and then close the gates and say, right, Rhodesia, farewell. And then burn as we go back. And it didn't happen. I was going to switch off the lights in Mtolia. But things are happening so fast at the moment. It just... I haven't got that much time anymore.
You're going and leaving the lights on?
That's right. Somebody else will have to switch them off.
Why don't you stay and take the gamble, take the risk?
Pete, there is no risk. I mean, there is no gamble, there is a risk, but there's no gamble. The gamble is all in the... The gooks have got it.
The who?
The gooks. The terrorists. The whole world is supporting the terrorists.
Has the attitude of Africans changed as a result of what is currently happening?
Yes. Yes.
In what way?
I got a staff, or the company I work with has got a staff of about eight Africans, and they all think they're going to own houses. And I've never seen so many Africans driving, learning to drive motor cars as what I have lately, because every one of them thinks they're going to get a motor car. A little garden, we call him a garden boy, was washing my mother-in-law's car. And he said to her, he says, well, next year, that's going to be my car. So my mother-in-law went to him and says, well, you see this box of matches or this lighter, I'll burn it before I give it to you. So that's the attitude of the African. It's changed completely. Ratios here at the moment, I think we are about 34. To one, maybe a bit more, with everybody taking a gap like me. In South Africa at the moment, I think it's about 4 to 1. I think about 4 to 1. So you could stand a chance.
Does that make you feel happier?
Well, I could take out 4 Effies before they take me out.
But you couldn't 36?
No way, sir.
Nothing?
Going through to Marcella?
Yep.
Right, just travel at about 100, 150 metres apart.
Mm-hmm.
You'll see there's a lot of people on the convoy that have, mm-hmm. you know, done it 100 times.
Mm-hmm.
Just do what they do, okay? Should you come under attack, go through, unless you're very well back and you can see the contacts well ahead.
Is the road very dangerous?
Oh, it's a bit dicey at the moment.
A few roads in Rhodesia are safe. Such is the guerrillas' tightening grip. 10 miles south of Umtali, we dropped out of the convoy at Zimunya. Here, the guerrilla's word was law.
This is, or was, the African township of Zimunya, a few miles outside of Umtali. Zimunya used to be a thriving township of about 1,500 Africans. That is, until a couple of months ago, when the terrorists moved in and told the people to get out. They did. Today, Zimunya is a ghost town.
I use the word terrorists because our government guide was listening. If I'd said guerrillas, a neutral word, there would have been trouble. Zimunya bears signs of a hasty retreat, the beer hall in ruins, the school in ashes. Exercise books littered the floor, some open at the date of the last lesson, October the 30th, 1978. Some left for the safety of Umtali, others caught the bus to Salisbury, 200 miles away. The sufferings of Rhodesia's 250,000 whites are well known, the plight of her 6 million blacks less so. Press and TV are heavily censored, journalists closely watched, accompanied most places. Africans caught in the middle are often frightened and confused. few